Hi folks, and welcome back to The Plot on a grey and miserable day. It does not really feel like spring anymore. I did get maybe slightly caught out by that false spring. You know, when it feels like something in your brain just starts to wake up when it starts getting warm. definitely maybe it caught me out a little bit. But we're hiding in the greenhouse today, and I thought it would be cool to talk to you about a few of the slightly more interesting varieties I'm planning on growing this year. I have got loads, but generally I've always done kind of a lot of staples, like quite often it's due to bad planning. So it suddenly gets to March and I go, wait a minute, there's like loads and loads of seeds I haven't ordered yet, and I haven't really thought about what I'm going to grow. Normally I have a rough kind of plan of where stuff is going to go in the garden, but then I just roll out and just get the standard, your gardener's delight, I can't even think of any common varieties of veg, but you know what I mean. You just kind of go out and you get whatever you find. But this year, I'm a little bit ahead of the game, as hopefully you've seen from my other videos. I'm thinking a little bit more about gardening. It's kind of always in the back of my mind, and I kind of credit that to Potty Mouth Garden Club, our live stream. Links in the description every Monday night. But yes, I thought I'd talk to you a little bit about the interesting seeds I'm growing, and as well, at the end, I'm going to show you this, which is a little mystery pack of seeds that I bought for 9p from Seed Parade. They didn't have many in stock. They might be back in stock now. I'll put a link in the description if they are. But they do a kind of out-of-date seed collection packet. And for 9p, I was quite impressed with what I got. So I'll show you that at the end. But some of the slightly more interesting ones. So I had a few sent to me very kindly by Grown Local, who started out with kind of a lot of microgreen stuff, but they also have loads of really interesting varieties that they've started selling of other fruit and veg. And I think they're really, really competitively priced. I know Ian from Grown Local, he's a really nice guy. We chat and he gives me tips on how to grow stuff because I don't know what I'm doing, as you've seen. But yeah, I was saying to him, you know, the prices of some of your stuff are genuinely really, really cheap. But the first one, and this is one that I've actually got growing already, is the Merlin cucumber. This is an F1 cucumber. And oh my goodness, it's like it's on rocket fuel. I've got two at the moment, the Merlin and the honey something. It's not honey crisp. The honey something cucumber. I'll show you some pictures because these are actually going. One issue with today's video, I've never grown most of these, so I won't have pictures, nice pictures that I can overlay. We're gonna have to exercise a bit of theatre of the mind. You're just gonna have to imagine the veg as I talk about it. But the second one he sent me is sweetcorn, which is something I'm really, really excited to have going properly on the second plot. You can see that plot tour up here if you haven't seen that. Very exciting news. But this one, Solstice F1, once again meant to be absolutely incredibly strong. And then I have a few that I got from Plants of Distinction, which is another quite cool website with some slightly unusual things. You know, they have some things that are a little bit strange, a little bit interesting. And I only got three from here because it can be a little bit pricey. But the first one is a butternut squash, and this one is called a honeynut. And this was a recommendation from Mark's Allotment Plot, link to his channel in the description, a member of the Potty Mouth Garden Club, really, really nice guy. Cool videos as well up in Scotland. So he's got some challenges with flooding and stuff as well. But this is similar to a traditional butternut squash, but it's a bit smaller and it's meant to have an incredibly sweet flavour. So I'm really looking forward to this. Butternut squashes are one of the few things that I do tend to actually have some success with. So I'm hoping I have some success with this as well, the honeynut squash. One reason I wanted to do this video as well is still, it's quite early in the season, so if you fancy the sound of any of these, you can definitely get some as well. Honey Plus, cucumber honey plus, that's one that I couldn't remember the name of. And this is one that I did get from Plants of Distinction, and then realised that Grown Local sells it cheaper, so I should have got it from him. But yeah, cucumber honey plus, looks really funky. Not much of a skin on it, meant to have a really sweet taste. It's growing quite slowly. They seem a little bit more delicate, especially compared to the Merlin, which is just like ready to go. So that's another one. I'm very excited to see how they go. I started those early as a bit of an experiment, kind of a blob. Kind of a Bob flower dew. Yeah, I see where the blob is going in now. Bob flower dew and Jesse at Plot 37 as well did some really early cucumbers last year. So a few of us are trying that. And this one is a French bean, I don't really do legumes. I've never really done them. This year, I'm kind of mending my ways. I did peas for the first time last year, if you can believe that. And I was like, oh, I get it. I see why people grow them. They are so much nicer. So I'm hoping the same is going to be true of French beans. And these ones, Cobra. These took ages to find. I think Steve Greenside Up recommended these on the Potty Mouth Garden Club a while back, probably in summer or something. And it took me ages to find these, but apparently Cobra are really nice. I think it's a flavour thing. I'm really looking forward to the comments because I'm sure you guys have probably grown most of these and you're laughing at me getting excited about these new varieties. So if you have grown them, very excited to hear from you. The next one, tiny little packet, one of these from Seed Parade, who I found out, they're quite a nice little website, but I found out their orders are fulfilled by Premier Seeds Direct. But when I went to do my big seed order this year, Premier Seeds Direct was down, so I just got them from Seed Parade. But the Gladiator F1 parsnip. I've never done parsnip, and in fact, I've bought lots of seed for parsnip before, but in the end, I didn't plant it because I thought, you know what, I haven't actually got enough room. Parsnips take up loads of room, and last year they were kind of lower on the priority list. But the Gladiator, we are doing a parsnip growing competition. There's not really too many details about exactly what rules there are in the competition yet, but if you do want to take part and laugh at my parsnips and feel better about your own, go ahead and get some Gladiator F1s, join the Potty Mouth Garden Club on Monday nights, and let us know how they go when you come to harvest. The next two are, once again, from Steve, Greenside Up. My description is going to be just full of other channels today, isn't it? But I've got a couple of squash plants, and like I say, squash plants are like one of the only thing that I actually tend to grow fairly successfully. And the first one is a spaghetti squash, which, not that uncommon. That is one that I had heard of quite a lot, but I'm really looking forward to trying this because it's just a bit different, isn't it? A bit funky. It's meant to kind of take on that spaghetti-like texture. You can do some cool stuff with it. I think the main reason that I love squash plants and what squash is because they just last for absolutely ages. They store so, so well. We've still got some butternut squashes that were harvested in October that are just going fine. They're going strong. We do need to make a soup out of them. This one, though, this is Steve's favourite squash. This one is Marina D. Chioggia. I think I've gone out on a limb with the pronunciation there, but I think it's Italian, so you get that K sound at the start. And this, probably the ugliest squash I've ever seen. Like I say, we might have to do a bit of theatre of the mind, but imagine a tiny little squash covered in kind of warts and boils and like grey. It's really, really ugly, but apparently one of the nicest tasting squash plants. So I'm excited. It's still way too early to sow most of these. What it isn't too early to sow, however, that was natural, wasn't it? What a natural transition. What it isn't too early to sow is tomatoes. We're coming into March now, and you could start to think about getting them going. I'm quite relaxed about my tomato start dates. Chilies, I'm like, yes, let's go. Tomatoes, not so much, but most of these were sent to me. It's actually like the first time I've ever really been sent lots of stuff, apart from when Jane from Jane's Growing Garden, once again, link in the description, sent me some melons last year, and they are once again on the go. I've given those a really early start. Not all of them. I've still got some seeds held back. You know, if you're going to do your cucumbers and your cucurbits, I used to think it was curcubits, but it's cucurbits, isn't it? Something like that. But yeah, if you're going to give those a go early, they're very tender, so just make sure you keep some seeds in backup. But tomatoes, that's what we're talking about. The first one is a Tachi tomato. Tachi? Not sure. But this is kind of like a Roma. It's like a paste tomato. And Audrey, I didn't say Audrey sent me these. Yeah, these are from Real Food Comes Dirty. Once again, amazing channel. She does loads of really cool live streams. Once again, joins us on the Potty Mouth Garden Club. And she sent me so many seeds. It was like Christmas when that package came. But yes, the Tachi tomato, paste tomato, meant to be absolutely amazing taste and really prolific as well. So I'm going to have a few paste tomatoes outdoors, and then some of the weirder ones are going to be in the greenhouse. The tomatoes that I'm most excited about, I've just realised, aren't here. I've left them at home. But I have some Brad's Atomic and some... Wait, what is it? Brad's Atomic Grape and Brad's Atomic Fusion as well, which most people will be familiar with. They're really popular on YouTube. And I've never grown anything like like that before. So I'm really, really excited, but I don't have them here because I'm an idiot. What we do have are these, which are black strawberry. And I've heard about these ones. These are meant to be really, really nice and just such a cool flavour, that kind of purple going into red with a bit of yellow as well. I'm excited about the tomatoes. I really am. I didn't do any last year, really. No, that's not true. That's not true at all. I tried to grow them last year, but I didn't do very well. But the year before, I didn't do any at all. So it's going to be the year. It's going to be the year for tomatoes. Next, we've got the indigo blue. Oh, just look at that. I really, really like the kind of dark coloured tomatoes. They're really, really cool. I'm excited. And we have this one as well, the orange accordion, which people have been raving about. Audrey absolutely loves, and loads of us are going to try and grow this year. I think these big beefsteaks are quite challenging, so make sure you subscribe and make sure you like the video as well, because that lets YouTube know that you're enjoying the video, and it might show you more of these, so later on in the year you can see me when I'm doing a nice little greenhouse tour and going, look at this, this has died and this has died. These tomatoes are rotting on the plant. That's great, isn't it? And here, the Sungold, the classic. Now, once again, I have never grown a Sungold. Can you believe that? A YouTube gardener who's never even tried Sungold. Apparently, the issue here is splitting. And these are really, really sweet. They're actually so sweet, it divides opinion. Steve, Greenside Up, was just recently saying that he actually doesn't like them because they're too sweet. Such a grumpy old man thing to say, isn't it? But hey, let's give it a go. I'm intrigued. I'm intrigued. I love it when something's a bit divisive. You know, you never know if you're going to love it or hate it. A couple more things from Audrey as well. She did send me some Calima beans as well, because I was saying that I've never really done beans. And she was like, oh, come on. Come on, what is wrong with you? So she sent me some of her favourite Calima and the Christmas Lima bean or Lima bean, depending on how you want to say it. So it's going to be a very, very interesting year for me. There are so, so many new varieties on the cards. And it's really, really cool getting them all out and talking about them. You can see the smile on my face. But 9p. What could you buy for 9p? I should as well remind you that I do have a Patreon. You can find all the links in the description. And an extra special thank you, as always, to my Chili Pepper tier patrons. There's loads of you now. I wasn't expecting to have this many, but four, but that's a lot to say in the middle of a video. So thank you to Tony, to Andrew, to Bill and Louise. I'm gonna have to start shortening those names so I can get through them. But 9p, how many seed packets did I get? These are from Seed Parade, as I said. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's pretty good, isn't it? That's almost a seed packet per penny. What's that, 1.2p? I'm not good at maths. There's a few flowers in here, so it's not all veg, but I'm going to give all of these a go, and we're going to see how this 9p seed packet goes throughout the year. The first, another bean, a dwarf French bean, Orinoco. Never heard of it, never seen it. Do you know, I haven't actually even really looked. I think I looked at these once when they arrived and went, that will make a fun little thing in a video. We've got some sorrel. There might be some fun pronunciation today. And when I hold it up to the camera, I can't actually read it on the screen because it's reversed. So I then have to go, French Green de Belville. French is not an accent I can do. Never grown sorrel, ever. Holy Basil. Not any Basil. Holy Basil. Ossimum Sanctum. It feels like I'm going to have to say it like that every time. Ossimum Sanctum. Oh, this is absolutely ridiculous. We've got some field poppies. These will be fun, I think, to maybe scatter around, kind of sow some field poppies, see what comes up, maybe under the apple trees. We've got some rosemary as well. So these aren't the most fascinating seeds, but for a penny a seed packet, it's definitely worth giving them a go, isn't it? It'll be interesting to see how badly the germination is affected. We've got, unfortunately, my detested, one of my least favourite plants, full-on Calabrese. This is called green sprouting, which I've only just seen when I looked at the packet. So Calabrese, as in like the full-headed broccoli, or Calabrese, if we want to just go full crazy on the pronunciation today. I've heard people say that, but is that even right? Anyway, green sprouting, I've literally never heard of green sprouting broccoli. I love purple sprouting broccoli, so in fact, I'm going to give this a go, and I haven't started my broccoli yet. you can get away with doing some of the purple sprouting and the green sprouting, I'm guessing, broccoli quite early in the season. Normally I start mine really early. Lots of people wait till kind of June, July to get their sprouting broccoli in. But if you go really early, you get massive plants. For a while, people were complimenting my purple sprouting broccoli plants. Like, you know, you can't grow anything, JB, but like, wow, your purple sprouting broccoli plants are crazy. I realised it's because I put them in the ground 3 months before everyone else. So they get a little bit of a head start. And the last packet in this mystery pack, a beetroot. Detroit 2. Is that interesting? I don't know. I haven't even Googled it. I haven't looked it up. This is a very raw video. But I might give a few of these a go. 400 seeds. You really cannot complain with that for 9p, I don't think. And the last, the honourable mention for, once again, one I've not done and one that's maybe a little bit interesting. This is the Sutton Dwarf broad bean. So once again, a recommendation from Steve. He really, really rates these, and it's nice to see we've got some germination. If you want to see what else is going on my plot, you can watch one of my recent allotment tours here. Also, these were planted by my lovely fiancée, Jess, and I thought she planted two in a pot, but might just be one. I love the surprises of gardening.